Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. For this week's book review, we are going to be doing The Bourne Ultimatum. If you guys have been enjoying the book reviews, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, also hit the notification bell so you can get notified when I drop my next video. Also, while you're down there, if you guys have any book recommendations you want me to do videos on in the future, you can leave those down in the comments as well. So, like always, our review format, summary of the story, pros, cons, and then my final thought and ranking. So, with all that out of the way, let's hit the intro. So for anyone who is new and has missed the last couple of book reviews for the first two books in this series, I will leave links down to those videos in the description so you can go check those out later. So let's finally get to the book review. So, this book actually takes place 5 years after the events of the second one. Damon and Maria have completely just settled into life and they have two really great kids and everything's going pretty well. One day, a super secret classified file detailing everything that's happened for the past 13 years gets exposed by a new generation Medusa who has operatives really, really high up within the US government. So this forces Jason to have to put Marie and the kids onto this island that's being run by Marie's brother. He's run this resort on this island, so it's a really good cover and it's a really good place to hide. So Bourne and Conklin go on this entire mission to try and expose all the various members of Medusa. This forces Medusa to hire Carlos the Jackal to take out Bourne, and Carlos cannot resist killing his old enemy for one last mission. Bourne and Carlos must fight for one last time to see who is the superior assassin. So our first pro is actually the better use of the Jason and David dynamic within this book. Right, so Robert Ludlum continues to advance this plot point, and it's a really, really important developmental plot point for both David the character and Jason the character as well, because we're constantly seeing this battle between David and Jason's personalities as far as what they think they need to do. David will push forward a little bit and we'll see certain thoughts, certain things that are specific to David, and then Jason has to kind of pounce on him, suppress the personality, and it's this constant battle that really makes the character continue to be interesting. As much as I really do like this plot point, it still continues to really be a kind of trouble spot within this series. Because I would personally really, really like there to be a psychological deep dive between the conflict of Jason and David. But because of the tone Robert Ludlum's going for, that sort of action adventure, it can't really work. Because the action needs to really drive the story. The psychological deep dive isn't as important as the story itself. And I kind of really understand why Robert Ludlum has to do this. But I feel like it's kind of disappointing. Because I don't think he can use this plot point to its best advantage. I think he really lets this plot point just kind of go. And he doesn't use it. And I would really like if we constantly see a battle between the two. Like, if Jason does something really crazy, we'll have David's reaction. But we don't get that. David really becomes just a non-entity when Bourne takes over, and I kind of don't feel like that's a good idea. Despite all my harping between David and Jason dynamic, I personally like it. I just wish Robert Ludlum had focused on it more, but with the tone he was going for, it really wouldn't have made sense. But what we do get in the story, I really like. That's all I'm just trying to say. He could have used it better, but what we do get, I do like. So, for our second pro, we are actually going to jump to Carlos the Jackal. So, if you guys had watched my first video, you know I really don't love how Ludlum used Carlos in the first book, and I feel like he finally fixed him in this book. So, with this book, Ludlum just cuts down on the time we see Carlos, and I feel like it works a lot better, because we understand Carlos' character. He just wants to kill Jason Bourne, and that's it. He's not any sort of deep emotional plotline. He's just out to go kill Jason and that's it. And I don't think we need to spend as much time as we did with him in the first book. And I think Ludlum really understood that and just let him be the villain of the third half of the book. And it really, really works a lot better. So our first con is actually Marie. And I am actually really, really just annoyed I have to put Marie in this con section, particularly for this book. Because I loved her in last book. Like I said in my other video, she had her own character. She was doing her thing. She was learning from Jason Bourne, and she was using what she learned to increase her own aspect in the story, and I really liked it. Whereas with this book, she's just kind of sidelined, and I'm like, come on, Ludlum. Marie's a really good character on her own. Just let her do her thing. And I get why Ludlum kind of had to sideline her. She was taking care of the kids. She was taking care of everything else. And it makes sense why they did that. But I'm kind of like, come on. We had a really good thing going on with Marie in the last book. She can do her own stuff. She can carry her own plot line. And I'm just kind of disappointed that Ludlum didn't take advantage of that and just sidelined her. Because I really like her. So for our second con, I have to add this really strange plot line Dr. Panoff gets that involves the mafia. But the main reason this is on here is how much of the story this gets. Because we cut back and forth to several, like, mafia-related things. And I'm like, this is just a strange plot line to devote sections of the book to. It's an interesting thing, but I don't necessarily think this was absolutely relevant. As funny as it is to see the mafia, I don't think it's relevant to what's going on. And just like with the Carlos plotline in the first book, he's spending a lot of time with this, and it's not entirely relevant. This time you're spending with the mafia thing could have been used a lot more effectively to develop Jason and David's battle, to keep developing Marie, to do a lot more important things that could make the story better in the long run than just shoving it over to the mafia plotline. Like, I just don't think it's relevant, and I don't really think he needed it in this book. So, despite how negative I've been seeming on this book, I personally do like it. It's a good read. I wouldn't discourage anyone from reading it if you do like the trilogy. I just think that this book isn't the Bourne series at its best. So, for this book review, I'm going to give The Bourne Ultimatum a 7 out of 10. If any of you guys have read The Bourne Supremacy before, I would be really interested in reading your reviews, so drop those down in the comments as well. Guys, this has been my review of The Bourne Supremacy. Thank you guys for watching. If you guys enjoyed, don't forget to like, share, subscribe. Also, don't forget to hit the notification bell so you can get notified when I drop my next video. So, if you guys have any book recommendations you want me to do, don't forget to drop those down in the comments. So, next week's video, I will be doing my personal rankings of the first three Bourne books, just like I did with King Chronicles. Sometime before that video comes out, I will drop a poll on my Instagram where you guys can vote on what series we will be doing next, and I will reveal which one won at the end of that. So, if you guys want a chance to participate in that poll, I will drop my Instagram link down in the description, and I will also have it appear on screen. So, I hope you guys have a good week, and I hope you guys enjoy my next video.